恬静安逸的南素里小区是不是您理想中的家园？繁华喧嚣的都市，何处寻觅令人向往的休闲生活？不过首先呢，我们还是为大家揭晓上一期留下的谜底。设计师 Alexandra 需要一周的时间才能让以望看房屋装饰后的结果。那么一周过去了， Alexandra 会给以望带来惊喜吗？马上进入这期的幸福有家。
经过一周时间的设计与布置，设计师 Alexandra 终于敞开了大门。
We want the buyer felt cozy, warm, inviting, a home that somebody can feel they can live in, and I feel we've helped to do that.
看来 Alexandra 对自己的作品信心十足。那么装饰后的豪宅会让看房者眼前一亮吗？首先，一起回顾一下房屋装饰前的模样。特别是那几处让房屋显得格外空荡与冰冷的地方，一进门看到的就是与家庭厅相连的走廊，如此的宽敞和通透，实在不知道应该摆放什么家具。
They can have a beautiful hall table right in the middle of the room, with beautiful flowers in it that make them feel happy when they come in.
红色的花束为空旷的走廊增添了不少色彩与活力。同时，这里也成为了屋内的一处小景观，屋主可以从各个角度来欣赏它。
From the top looking down, they look beautiful. So it's a really nice feature in the home. You can see it from the living room, you can see it from dining room, family room, and even a little bit from the kitchen.
透过红色花束，视线进入到了后面空旷的家庭厅。但是首先来看一下进门处这个高达20英尺的墙面，又空又高又窄。
We wanted the eye to go up towards the ceiling because it's so beautiful, and the chandeliers there, and the beautiful architectural detail on the ceilings.
一般的设计也许只会挂一幅画，但 Alexandra 就在墙上挂上两幅相互映衬的挂画，从而吸引屋主的眼光向上看去，一探究竟，化解了墙的高度与空旷。不过紧接着，墙另外一面的一体式餐厅与客厅的空旷又显露了出来。
Felt really long and narrow, so it felt confusing as to where people would put their furniture and would how would sofas fit properly.
看来狭长性的布局很具有挑战性。不过 Alexandra 说，只要掌握好一个标准，就不会出错。
But large rooms, you have to be sure that you bring in the right scale of furniture, because if you bring furniture in that's too small.It just won't feel right at all.
大小正好的黑白沙发完美地利用了空间，而壁炉上方也选用了有个性的圆形镜子。不过这个镜子的摆放位置刚好还有另外一个妙处。
It reflects the beautiful chandelier in the entry, so it adds more sparkle.
到目前为止，问题才解决了一半。紧邻的餐厅又该如何解决呢？ Alexandra 选择了不同于一般的餐椅。
We brought in, beautiful dining chairs that can actually be used as living room chairs too because they have beautiful arms on them and they're nice and big. We wanted to have the table and chairs balance. It's because there's a huge chandelier above it, a beautiful crystal chandelier.
原来桌椅的选择还要考虑到顶灯的风格，不然有可能产生搭配不当的效果。现在再从大门看一遍，感觉是否比以前更有家的温馨呢？其实把餐厅布置成这样还有一个原因，它解决了一个房屋构造方面的缺陷。
When it was vacant, it was really noticeable, and my eye went to that right away.
Alexandra 说的就是楼梯与餐厅相连的入口，因为楼梯的延伸快要进入餐厅，使得这里非常狭窄。
Our focus was to draw the eye away from that negative, draw the eye more into the dining room by making it look so beautiful and creating a positive.In the situation.
接下来可以揭晓走廊后面的家庭厅了。之前给人的感觉是空间大，而且色彩单调。Alexandra 是怎么做的呢？
We brought in a large sectional, which is 103 inches wide, whereas the standard sofa is 82 inches wide.
同时还有咖啡桌和地毯。 Alexandra 说，这样不仅添加了人气，还增添了层次感。
The wall, the beautiful windows, then you've got a layer of curtains, and then in front of that you have the sofa, and then in front of that you have the rug, and so it's just layer upon layer, creating more depth, which makes the room feel larger and way more interesting.
走过门厅、家庭厅，就到了厨房。设计师 Alexandra 说，因为厨房的装潢非常有个性了，只要进行适当的点缀，比如橘子和花盆就可以了。一层布置的差不多了，走上楼梯，立刻迎来的又是空旷的过渡空间。
Felt dark and empty, and wondering what would a person do with this space.
这里可以做成工作区或者是欣赏空间，不过 Alexandra 最后决定布置成屋主休息看书的地方。
We brought lighting in as well to lighten it up, so it removed the darkness. Brought a rug because it's just hardwood floor, so that made it feel darker too.
Alexandra 说，整体房屋的感觉就是传统与现代风格的融合，而选用部分古典风格的家具也是为了增添家的温馨。在全部布置好后， Alexandra 终于让以望看结果了，他看后会满意吗？
我希望客人一进门，他们目光所及之处全部是美丽的，那这个是达到了。
好了，设计师 Alexandra 的任务已经完成了，接下来房子的销售就要看房产经纪以望的了。
我希望最后的结果是好的。
在这里，我们幸福有家栏目也祝愿以望可以将房屋顺利售出。在安家时，我们一般都不喜欢吵闹的地方，但您是否知道，在繁华喧嚣的市中心也能找到都市风格的休闲生活。